So George, moving to other mechanisms, you mentioned the Yamanaka factors. So as you mentioned, Shinya Yamanaka won the 2012 Nobel Prize for identifying these four factors that create what are called induced pluripotent stem cells. So an adult cell can become a stem cell. And then there have been some recent papers about how to use those Yamanaka factors to reverse age mice. Maybe talk a little bit about that and about parabiosis, the research that's been done connecting an old mouse and a young mouse and looking how the young mouse gets older and the old mouse gets younger.
Right. So these are among many that have been well established in animals, worms, flies, and mice mainly, where you can either get longevity, where from birth they have the right genes, or there are a smaller subset of experiments where you actually reverse it during their lifetime, mm-hmm. including the Yamanaka factors and the blood components. If you look, there's a database of hundreds of these genes that have been well curated, and what we're doing is turning them into gene therapies. So this is a very good way of doing both rapid prototyping, but also possibly a mature therapy. There are now 2,400 gene therapies in clinical trials, and it's very easy to go from a hypothesis, from the literature, to a gene therapy. We can do 60 at once with just a couple of postdocs. And so we take pre-aged mice that are 2 years old, and then the gene therapies that work in those, we move into pre-aged dogs, 12 years old, and we're looking for things that will have an effect there. But we're looking for something that has a body-wide physiological impact.